Okay, students. A ray is a line with an endpoint and it extends infinitely in another direction A ray is a line with an endpoint and it extends infinitely in another direction. Draw this figure. Students, you are observing right side arrow is there. Means right side I can extend infinitely. Means one side I can extend infinitely, that is ray. Suppose this point is O and this A. I want to represent ray OA. How to write? Ray OA, or I can write OA with symbol. Next, keep one star point. A ray has one end point it extends endlessly in one direction only. A ray has one endpoint, it extends endlessly in one direction only. Means only one direction we can extend infinitely, but another direction we can't. You are observing, students, ray has only one endpoint and line segment have two endpoints. But line has how many endpoints? Line don't have any endpoint. Okay. Now keep adding, everyone. Collinear points. collinear points. Collinear points. If three or more points If three or more points lie on the same straight line, If three or more points lie on the same straight line, they are called collinear points. If three or more points lie on the same straight line, they are called collinear points. Otherwise, they are called non-collinear points. Non-collinear points. In simple way, we can say, students, what is the meaning of collinear? If three or more than three points are lying on the same line, that is called collinear. If three or more than three points are lying in the different line, that is called non-collinear. Suppose one example I am writing here. Check it here, everyone. So I have drawn one line. In this point is A. This point is B. This point is C, and this point is D. In this figure, students, you are observing point A, B, C, and D are lying on the same straight line. That is called collinear points. Note down, everyone. Collinear points. This is collinear. This is collinear. No, why no? Because line is straight line. A to B is the straight line, again bend. Again C to D is straight line, but it is bend. This is non-collinear points. Point A, B, C, D is non-collinear. Now we are going to start actual concept, key fading angle. Key fading angle. An angle is formed what is angle an angle is formed an angle is formed when two rays when two rays an angle is formed when two rays originate from the same endpoint originate from the same endpoint What is angle? An angle is formed when two rays originate from the same endpoint. What is the meaning of originate here? Originate means comes into existence. What is originate? Comes into existence. What is angle? An angle is formed when two rays originate from the same endpoints. In this figure, there are two rays. First ray I am mentioning OA. Second ray is OB. I have given definition of angle. An angle is formed when two rays originate from the same endpoint. O is the same endpoint. This is called angle. An O point is also called as common initial point or vertex. O point is also called as common initial point or vertex. If two lines are meeting at one point, that point is called not two line. If two or more than two line are meeting at one point is called common initial point or vertex. This point is called vertex. In second way, we can say common initial point. Common initial point. If two or more than two rays are meeting at one point, that point is called common initial point or vertex. Yeah. What is acute angle? What is the meaning of acute angle? What is the meaning of acute angle? An angle which is greater than 0 degree and less than 90 degree. An angle which is greater than 0 degree and less than 90 degree, that is called acute angle. What is obtuse angle? Angle which is greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, that is called obtuse angle. Next, what is right angle? Don't say greater than, less than. Right angle means the angle which is exactly equal to 90 degree, that is called right angle. Then what is straight angle? The angle which is exactly equal to 180 degree, that is called straight angle. Understood? Next, reflex angle. What is reflex angle? An angle which is greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree, that is called reflex angle. Last angle is what? Complete angle. The angle which is exactly equal to 360 degree, that is called complete angle. Got it, everyone? Then what is zero angle? Zero degree angle, the angle which is zero, that is called zero degree angle. Got it? Now we are going to learn types of angles. Keep heading, everyone. Left side, types of angles. Types of angles. There are different types of angles. There are different types of angles. There are different types of angles. First angle is acute angle. First angle is acute angle. An angle which measures an angle which measures an angle which measures between 0 degree and 90 degree, between 0 degree and 90 degree. Example, 40 degree, 70 degree, 80 degree, 79 degree, 89 degree. 91 degree is acute angle. 91 degree is not acute angle because this angle is greater than 90 degree. Second, obtuse angle. An angle which is greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. example, ninety one degree, one not two degree, 175 degree, 179 degree, 181 degree, 181 degree is not obtuse angle. This is greater than 180 degree. Third is right angle. An angle which is equal to 90 degree. An angle which is equal to 90 degree an angle which is equal to 90 degree is called right angle. Next, fourth is straight angle. An angle whose measure is 180 degree. An angle whose measure is 180 degree whose measure is 180 degree is called straight angle. Next, fifth, reflex angle. Reflex angle. An angle whose measure an angle whose measure is greater than 180 degree an angle whose measure is greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree is called reflex angle. students, today I have explained types of angles. Tomorrow again I will explain, I will ask this all types of angles. Today go to home, revise very properly. Example. Suppose I am writing here 184 degree. This angle is greater than 180 and less than 360, that is called reflex angle. 274, 75 degree.